Here's the room I made for my boys. I wanted to have a nautical theme, so I have these bunk beds. The top one's suspended and completely independent of the bottom one. It's tied with these anchors there, and with rope up to the wall and a knot. And it's pretty sturdy. It can move up, but it can't move down. And we've had a lot of people up on there. So I'll tell you a bit about how it was done. I made two frames out of oak, and I cut them 45 degree angles, and then I have two pan head lag bolts that are about that long, at least 6 inches. They go through there and here, and then also on the other side coming forward. These are actually oak handrails. I got some lumber cheap, so I decided to do this. And then underneath, it's just a sheet of plywood. I stained it and I screwed on, actually just nailed on, a wood lip all the way around. And there's no supports in between here, just one sheet of plywood, and it works perfectly. And while we're down here, there's a lag bolt right there going into a stud. There's one there and one there, so three lags holding it into studs on the wall. This anchor is just for decoration, but this one's anchored into a stud and is support. So without this one anchored securely, this bed would not work like this at all. The rope is just a thick twine rope from Home Depot. And this is bound just like actual nautical rigging. It's wound and really tight, and then painted black to keep it secure from slipping. It just slips over here. These are not lag bolts. These are actual bolts. I had to drill a couple holes and throw some nuts under there, so it goes down, and never had any trouble or issues with this. My son uses this to climb up, kind of monkeys up, and it works really well. So the tie, the boat anchor tie metal bracket here, is bolted into two pieces of oak, and those two pieces of oak are screwed into the structural elements of the wall. So what you'd want to do, preferably, I put on crown molding. So I cut open the wall and reinforced it, because if I just tied into a stud right here and they didn't do a good job nailing the stud and a lot of weight was put on this, it could, you know, do some damage. So, but if you don't have crown molding and you put this even higher, you could nail in to the beam that's going straight across, and that would be really secure. Because I have crown molding, I had to go lower, and then the stud was the only secure part of that. So then just tie the knot really tight. Let's say one trick with doing the knots, if you decide to do this, is I slip it on there, then wind it up and have some excess. If it's a little too saggy still, you know, if you look down here and this edge is drooping, what you do is you unhook it here and spin the rope. So since the twine is going this way, I'd spin it like this. That tightens up the rope, and it also lifts up the bed. So if it's drooping a bit, you just spin the rope a bit, then re-slip it around this anchor, and it jacks up the bed enough to make it level. This It wasn't the perfect bedding, but it really matches the paint pretty well. I got this. This is a Target bedspread. They didn't sell it in stores anymore, but I found it online. It's, let's see if there's a tag here. Circo, what do you call it? Well, I'll put it in the description. And these lights here are from IKEA. And I drilled a little hole in here to hide the wire down the wall. And I got these dimmers here, so they make nice reading lamps. Those wall plates were from those, and they matched the style of the lamp. You could see perfectly. Straight lines, clean lines, chrome and black. And my boys absolutely love those reading lamps. They use them all the time, so I was glad I put them in. Got a Hunter Douglas fan here. It's black and chrome. And what are their elements? The curtains. Let's see if I can get away with not having the funky lighting. Curtains were from IKEA as well. I wanted something somewhat similar to a sail, so I just had white sheets with eyelets at the top. Doesn't feel too unnautical. Again, crown molding all the way around. Little metal Jeep poster here. And I'm going to take this painting down and put some IKEA shelves up in the next video. If you want to watch how those are installed. They're the shelves that have no supports underneath. They just come straight out of the wall. And they match the same wood color. They're chrome and chrome and like ebony or whatever they call it. Just a really dark brown. So that should look pretty good. I'll talk about how this bed goes in. So underneath this bed are just, these are just furniture legs that I came across for like a sofa, just a block of wood. And pull it out. You can see that this bed has nothing to do with the top. So you can move it around, do anything you want. And under here, it's just the sheet of plywood. It's just resting on the lip that was nailed on. It did help fortifying this. This is, I'm up second story here, as you can see. And actually, my house is a lot like my neighbor's. I have this, so here's a bedroom right here, and I have this big triangle shape in the attic. It was just dead space. So here, cut a hole in the wall and made a pretty big playroom. They do their Legos and hang out and wrestle in here. And this was such a big amount of space, as you can see. It would be a shame just to leave it attic. So that allowed me to cut open here and do a lot of retrofit for holding the one beam. So the key to this bed is this here. And let me show you. Down the side, it's probably too dark, but let me move this. I can go on this side maybe. Turn on the reading lamp a little bit more. Can the lens make it down there? I don't think so. Anyway, right there you see the reflection. There it is a little bit. See the little white thing? That's a bushing from a skateboard truck, they're called. The truck is a part of the skateboard that holds the wheels, and it also attaches to the board. And there's these little rubber bushings. So this lag bolt is not going straight into the wall. If you bolted a piece of wood straight against the wall, your wall, more often than not, it's not gonna be framed perfectly straight. So it'll be a bit wobbly. And every time they get in the bed, you'll hear it creaking and hitting the wall, it would be terrible. So I put one bushing in between the bed frame and the wall. So each of the three lag bolts has one little rubber bushing, and that gives it a cushion. So when boys jump on here, it doesn't transfer all that energy directly into the studs, causing creaks and damaged sheetrock and all that. So that's a vital part of the construction of this as well. Anyway, I hope that's been helpful, give you something to think about. It was a pretty fun project. This paint is a three-tone, so the ceiling's flat brown, and then this is kind of a cream colored, it's not white, and then the blue is a nice color blue that works very well. It was a combination I didn't come up with, but I saw it in a magazine, so I'll put the paint colors in the description as well, so in case you wanted to do this. And if you do, leave some comments, maybe anything that you found helpful or some different ideas that you had, maybe help other people. The only thing, I mean, we didn't put up enough decorations yet. I still wanted to do a lot of fun stuff in here. The curtains are kind of boring. I wish I could fancy them up a little more boatish. This, I wish I could find bedding that's just stripes or something. But it's good. So if you find awesome bedding that's great for a nautical room, leave that in the comments as well. And anyway, ask questions and I'll answer them. Thanks for watching.